I'm about to lose the battle and cross the line. I'm about to make another mistake. And even though I try.
Dear friends all over the world, welcome back again. This is Mr. Osama Mukbil, the English teacher and the self-improvement coach. How are you doing? Hopefully you are doing great, all of you. I know that you are laughing at my beautiful sunny glasses, because you are so jealous of them. You don't have a beautiful and awesome sunglasses like these ones. Anyways, I think that these are not sunglasses. These are planetary glasses. Dear friends, in the previous episode, we learned to govern a couple of idioms, such as to be on a cloud nine, to be down in the dumps, to be up to your neck, up to your ears, up to your eyes, and so on and so forth. You should know that one of the most important and effective ways to improve your fluency is to memorize as many idioms as possible. And you should remember that these idioms are used in everyday language by native speakers. So, if you know well how, when, and where you should use these idioms, you can improve your fluency considerably. But the big question here is, how to memorize these idioms? The number one strategy you have to bear in mind 24/7 is to keep practicing and practicing and practicing and practicing all the time with love, passion, enthusiasm, determination, and positivity. Today, I'm going to guarantee you to improve your fluency, and you won't have those difficulties when you want to talk. Today, we're going to learn 7 more idioms. If you memorize them and practice them the way I'm going to teach you with, I promise you that you will notice a very wonderful difference between your level now and your level 1 month or 2 months later, if you follow my instructions to the letter. 7 idioms, you have to memorize them, you have to practice them at least 10 up to 15 times per day with love, passion, enthusiasm, determination, and positivity. Don't feel bored. Don't say, no, I'm sick and tired of practicing them, because you are looking for fluency, for professionalism, for natural performance. So if you want to improve your speaking skill, listen to my brotherly advice and you will notice the awesome and indescribable results yourself. All you have to do is just stay with me so that you get these 7 idioms and memorize them, just to make them as your second nature. So let's set the ball rolling. Here we go, dear friends. At first, we're going to know the meaning of each idiom one by one, and then after that, I'll tell you how to memorize these idioms. Number one, he is as busy as a beaver. I think that the first idiom is very familiar with you because we learned it together in the previous episode. When someone is busy all the time, you can't say to him, oh bro, I think that you are as busy as a beaver or as busy as a bee. Number two, he is as brave as a lion. He is as brave as a lion. Now, you know that the lion is fearless, doesn't fear at all. So if someone is very, very fearless and so brave, so courageous, you can't say to him, hey, bro, you are as brave as a lion. Number three, he is as proud as a peacock. He's as proud as a peacock. You know, the peacock is a very beautiful bird that has a stunning tail that spreads it like this just to show its beauty. So if you see someone so arrogant, so haughty and very showy, you know that you can say to him, oh bro, I think that you are as proud as a peacock. You are as proud as a peacock. Number four, he is as slow as a snail. The snail is a small creature that has a shell on its back, and it's very, very slow. So if you see someone very slow and so lazy, you can describe him as slow as a snail. He is as slow as a snail. Number five, he is as stubborn as a mule. He is as stubborn as a mule. Stubborn is the person who doesn't change his mind easily. If you give him numbers, statistics, you know, reasons, experiences, anything else, you know, he doesn't change his mind. He just does whatever he wants. The mule is an animal, the offspring of the horse and donkey. It's not a horse, it's not a donkey either. You know, it's the offspring of a horse and a donkey. So we can say that, oh, bro, you are as stubborn as a mule. Why didn't you want to come with us to the party? It's very nice. There are a lot of great activities you can enjoy there. So please come with us. I don't want. Oh, bro, I think that you are as stubborn as a mule. Okay? Next. He is as cunning as a fox. You know, the fox is a very tricky animal. So if you see someone who is dishonest or very tricky, you can say, oh, I think that she is as cunning as a fox. Or he is as cunning as a fox. The last one here is, he is as docile as sheep. You can pronounce it docile or docile. Docile is the American pronunciation. Docile is the British pronunciation. So it's up to you. You can use either the first or the second. He is as docile as sheep. Docile means easily controlled, easily dominated. We can't say characterless. The one whose character is very poor and extremely weak. So if someone is easily persuaded, easily dominated, easily controlled, you can't say, uh-oh, I think that this person is as docile as sheep. Now, what about memorizing these seven idioms automatically? As you see the seven letters here, B, B, P, this is the first group, S, S, the second group, and finally C, D. And these are the letters as you see, you know, the first letter of each adjective in each idiom. He is as, you should just say it like this. He is as, he is as, he is as, he is as, he is as. Practice, 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 practice. Repeat, 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 and repeat all the time. He is as, he is as, he is as. You have to say these idioms fast so that you can be automatic, natural, spontaneous, and so on. So, he is as busy as a beaver. 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 He's as brave as a lion. He's as brave as a lion. He's as brave as a lion. He's as proud as a peacock. He's as proud as a peacock. The three idioms one more time. He's as busy as a beaver. He's as brave as a lion. He's as proud as a peacock. The second group. He's as slow as a snail. He is as slow as a snail. He is as slow as a snail. He is as stubborn as a mule. He is as stubborn as a mule. He is as stubborn as a mule. So we have two idioms in the second group. He is as slow as a snail. He is as stubborn as a mule. The last group, he's as cunning as a fox. He is as cunning as a fox. He is as cunning as a fox. He is as cunning as a fox. The last one, he is as docile as sheep. 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 B, B, P, S, S, C, D. B, B, P, S, S, C, D. He is as busy as a beaver. He is as brave as a lion. He's as proud as a peacock. He is as slow as a snail. He is as stubborn as a mule. He is as cunning as a fox. And finally, he is as docile as sheep. I'm going to repeat them one more time so that you remember how to memorize them and to practice them automatically. Here we go. Remember the seven letters B, B, P, S, S, C, D. One more time. B, B, P, S, S, C, D. Let's go. He is as busy as a beaver. He is as brave as a lion. He is as proud as a peacock. He is as slow as a snail. He is as stubborn as a mule. He is as cunning as a fox. And he is as docile as sheep. One more time. Remember, practice makes perfect. Practice makes perfect. Practice makes perfect. Seven letters, B, B, P, S, S, C, D. Here we go. He is as busy as a beaver. He is as brave as a lion. He is as proud as a peacock. He is as slow as a snail. He is as stubborn as a mule. He is as cunning as a fox. And he is as docile as sheep. You can do it. I'm sure 100% that you can memorize these seven idioms automatically and naturally. All you have to do is just to keep listening and watching this video so that you absorb all the idioms, to make them your second nature. And you don't make any great efforts when you repeat them over and over and over again. Just remember to practice them at least 10 up to 15 times per day with love, passion, enthusiasm, determination, and positivity. Until I see you again, don't forget that you are great enough, excellent enough, awesome enough, confident enough, powerful enough, and positive enough to be persistent and to keep practicing all the time to improve your level, to raise your standards, and enhance your speaking skill as greatly, considerably, and wonderfully as possible. Until I see you again, I wish you an awesome weekend full of love, inner peace, and all kinds of ecstasy. Thank you so much, and have a nice weekend. Bye-bye. My heart is so full of regret. Forgive me.